Hello, Odooers. Today we're going to see how our company, Stealthy Wood, can use automatic reordering rules. When managing our warehouse, we consider our current stock, pending sales orders, and vendor delivery times. That's a lot of moving parts to consider, which is why large warehouses like Stealthy Wood opt for automatic reordering rules. Odoo lets me skip reviewing all of these purchase orders and calculates reorders for me. If this sounds like something you'd like, keep watching and I'll show you how to set it up. First, let's take a look at our existing reordering rules. I'll go to the inventory app, click on the configuration subheading, and head to reordering rules. These are the reordering rules we already have set up. Let's create a new rule by clicking new. And we'll set it to one of our most popular products, the battery. I'll set the minimum quantity to 4 and the maximum to 20. And just like that, our reordering rule is ready. Since I only have 3 batteries in stock, the reordering rule will automatically generate a request for quotation for the max quantity minus the forecasted quantity. So that would be 20 minus 3, which is 17. So we'll be reordering 17 batteries. You also may be wondering why there is this little blue truck sign over here. This is an order once button that will manually trigger a reordering rule. Let's go ahead and check it out. Oh, and it looks like we have an error message reminding us that we haven't set up a vendor yet for this product, so we can't create a request for quotation. Let's go ahead and fix that by clicking on the Edit Product button. Here we are on the batteries product form. I'll go to the Purchase tab and add a default vendor to buy from. I'm going to add a line and type in battery vendor. And for the price, we'll set it to 2. And for the delivery lead time, we'll set it to 3 because after ordering, it'll take 3 days for the products to arrive at Stealthy Wood. Now that we're done setting up the vendor, let's go back by clicking on the reordering rules breadcrumbs. So remember, Odooers, to generate an automated request for quotation or RFQ properly, not only do you need to set a minimum and maximum quantity rule on this page, you also need to set up a default vendor. Only then a reordering rule can be triggered when the forecasted quantity falls below the minimum. Alrighty, so with the reordering rules all set, let's go ahead and trigger it. I can either confirm a sales order for the battery, which I'll do later in the video, or run the scheduler. For that, we need to turn on developer mode. Mine's already on, evident by this bug icon at the top right over here. Alrighty, let's head to the operations subheading and click on the run scheduler action. The scheduler checks for updated product quantities and activates any reordering rules, which run once a day by default. Since I just created this reordering rule, we'll have to manually run the scheduler to activate it right now. Otherwise, it would be activated when the reordering rules runs automatically tomorrow. So let's run the scheduler. And boom, the request for quotation is created. We can tell because the truck button to order once is gone now. We can go to the purchase app to confirm the purchase order or do it right here by clicking on this blue graph icon for the battery. This takes us to the forecasted reports chart. We can see our request for quotations here at the bottom. We can also open the linked purchase over here. I'd like to note that even though a reordering rules automatically created an RFQ for us, we still need to manually confirm it. So we'll do that by clicking on the confirm order at the top over here. And look what we have here. A smart button was automatically generated. Let's go ahead and check it out. We'll validate the receipt, mark it as all done, and now we have 20 batteries in stock. Now the method I just showed you is a catch-all for triggering reordering rules, especially during initial setup or when the stock count is adjusted. Odoo doesn't automatically run the scheduler in these situations, so we need to trigger it manually. Luckily for us, the scheduler activates reordering rules every time we confirm a sales or purchase order. So let's see what that looks like. Let's start by going to the sales application. Let's click new to create a new quotation. And for the customer, let's put Alice. And she's going to be purchasing 24 batteries. Now, before confirming the sales order, which would trigger the reordering rule, let's do a quick check to verify that no purchase orders have been created for this product. To do that, we'll click on the graph icon, which tells us that we have 20 batteries in stock. And then let's click on the View Forecast button. This brings us to the forecasted report table. The bottom forecasted inventory line shows us that we have 20 units in stock. Alice's order after confirmation demands 24 units, resulting in a deficit of 4 units according to the forecasted with pending line. Since the purchase order has yet to appear in the table, the reordering rule has not been triggered. So, quick math question, Odooers. How many batteries will our reordering rule order for us? Since the quantity to order is the maximum in the reordering rule minus the forecasted quantity, 20 plus 4 is 24 units. Let's check if our math is correct by going back to the quote using the breadcrumbs. And let's go ahead and confirm the order. And we'll head back to the forecasted report via the graph and view forecast. And here's the RFQ that we were waiting for. Down here in the request for a quotation line, we see that an RFQ for 24 units has been generated just like we expected. Okay, Odooers, we're in the final stretch here. So let's click on the RFQ link. All that's left to do is confirm the order, receive the products, validate it, and mark as all done. And now we have more than enough products for Alice's order and more. And there you have it, Odooers. Today we learned how to use automatic reordering rules and how to run the scheduler. You guys are so smart, so I trust that after I showed you guys the technical details, you understand how quantities to reorder are determined. Alrighty, that's enough math today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.